She deleted 33,000 emails. She should be in jail for that. I don't even care if they're very highly confidential emails. I don't care what.
So what is the state of this investigation into Hillary Clinton's emails at the State Department?
So, Dana, you'll remember, I was close to this even when I was a member of Congress, when I served on the Benghazi committee now, what seems like a little bit time ago. We've got the emails. We're getting them out. We're going to get all this information out so the American people can see it. You'll remember, there was classified information on a private server. It should have never been there. Hillary Clinton should never have done that. It was unacceptable behavior. It's not the kind of thing that leaders do. They don't put that kind of information out. And you can see, whether it's Russia or China or Iran or the North Koreans who want to get their hands on this kind of information, classified information needs to stay in the right places. Secretary Clinton, when she was here at the State Department, did not do that.
The president has the authority to declassify anything he wants. All authority is to him. Could he declassify it and order it released if he wanted to and if he ordered?
Absolutely. We're going to get there. We're going to get this information out so the American people can see it.
If he were to order that, would there be concerns about maybe health and safety of sources or methods that could possibly be in these emails if there's classified information?
So, Dana, I've been at this a long time with President Trump for 4 years now almost. I've never seen him do anything that would put any kind of asset, any kind of one of our officers in any harm's way. He wouldn't do that. We'll get the information out that needs to get out, and we'll do it in a way that protects the intelligence sources that we need to protect.
And last question on that, will that happen before the election?
Doing it as fast as we can. I certainly think there'll be more to see before the election.